Now I am presenting the diagram, a picture. You can see that a number of parts. Now it starts with the nasal cavity, okay? And the nasal cavity is a present here, and then next the pharynx is there, larynx is there, next trachea also there. Then it is dividing to bronchus and bronchioles, these all. Now we have to learn about this entire system from starting itself. The two outer openings here, already you know that, right? This we called as nostrils, right? See, these two outer openings we called as nostrils. So through the nostrils, the air is enter. When it is occur during the inhalation.
Inhalation. Okay?
Yes, very good. So inside, a number of hairs are present. Okay, a fine hairs are present, and the walls of the walls of the nostrils also lined with mucous membrane. So while the air is passing through, enter into our nostrils and passing into the nasal cavity, the mucous membrane and the hairs are trapping the dust particles which are present present in the air. Then the air passing to nasal cavity, and in the nasal cavity again the mucous membrane is present. So that walls are lined with mucous membrane. So what is the function of mucous membrane here? The mucous membrane is regulating the air which we intake, okay, equivalent to our body temperature, right? Then the nasal cavity leads to pharynx. Already you know about the pharynx. You learned about the pharynx in digestive system. Okay, what you learned, this is a funnel-like structure, right, which is a common passage to air as well as food, right? So this air is passing through the pharynx and enter into the larynx, which we termed as voice box. Then the air is entered into the long tube-like structure, which we called as a trachea, right? So here we have to discuss about a trachea also. What is the meaning of this trachea? What is the structure of the trachea? We have to know.
It is pipe.
Yeah, very good. These trachea constructed with C-shaped cartilaginous rings. Okay, what is the function of these cartilaginous rings, C-shaped rings? Here, these C-shaped cartilaginous rings are preventing from collapsing our closed system of trachea when less air is present inside of it, right? Then the air passing now into that two branches. Now what happened? These trachea starts at the throat area and traveling up to the chest cavity, which we called as a thoracic cavity, right? Okay, so at the area of the thoracic cavity, it is a divide into two branches. Okay, two branches. So these two branches, bronchus we call two branches, and each branch is left and right enter into the lungs. Okay, how many lungs we have? Two lungs, right? One pair of lungs we have, right? That is as right and left lung. Okay, right. Yeah. So this right lung is constructed with three lobes, while the left lung is constructed with two lobes. Okay. So now the bronchus divide into two, and these bronchi enter into the lungs. Then it is divided into number of branches, fine branches, and those all branches are just penetrate into the lungs, right? And this end of these bronchi we called as the bronchioles, which are opens into the sac-like structures called as alveoli. The alveoli are sac-like structures which is covered with the capillaries. Okay, right. Now this actually the alveoli site of the gas exchange. Okay, gas exchange will occur in that area only. Okay, now coming to back lungs, we have to know about the lungs also. No, these right lung is, I said, in a right lung three lobes are present, and in a left lung two lobes are present. So right lung is a larger in size comparatively left lung. Okay, right. Why the left lung is very small? Already you know, you learnt about the circulatory system and in the heart, and heart location and everything, right?